Thank you, family, for joining me again this week. My name is Shannon Jackson, your resident host. And today we're talking about CHF, also known as congestive heart failure or just plain old heart failure.
Wake up, everybody. Let's elevate your mind.
The CDC estimates about 6.2 million adults in the United States will have heart failure at some point. What exactly is congestive heart failure, also known as CHF, or abbreviated as heart failure? Heart failure happens when the heart cannot pump enough blood and oxygen to support the other organs in your body. Heart failure is a serious condition, but it does not mean that the heart has stopped beating completely. Rather, it means that the heart muscle has become less able to contract over time or has a mechanical problem that limits its ability to fill with blood. As a result, it can't keep up with the body's demand, and blood returns to the heart faster than it can be pumped out. Thus, it becomes congested and backed up. So let's discuss some of the risk factors of CHF. There are certain medical conditions that can increase your risk for heart failure. And these may include, but not limited to, coronary artery disease, which is one of the most common heart diseases, having a heart attack, that old diabetes, high blood pressure, obesity, respiratory infections. So how is it diagnosed? As of right now, there is not one single test that is used to diagnose heart failure. However, your doctor will consider your medical history, family history, physical exam, and various tests. Some of those tests include the following: having an EKG, having a chest x-ray, which is a picture of your heart and lungs and other chest structures, a BNP, which is a blood type. It's a hormone that is a marker of a severity and prognosis of the heart failure. An echocardiogram, an ultrasound of the heart. Now that's different than another test that's called a Doppler ultrasound, which gives you a picture of the blood flow to the heart and the lungs. And lastly, a Holter monitor, measures of your heart electrical activity taken by a portable device that you wear for a day or two. Many times your physician will have you go home with this, and then you have a certain time to bring it back. So family members, take care of yourself. How can we be preventative? By having a healthy diet, regular exercise, stop smoking if you're a smoker, get a physical exam each year, and make sure that if you already have congestive heart failure, that you follow your regimen that your doctor has set up with you. And oftentimes they'll put you on a certain plan where you have to weigh so many times a week, you have to watch for certain signs and symptoms so that they can prevent you from going into full congestive heart failure. So if you enjoy today's lesson on congestive heart failure, please make sure you click the notification button and subscribe to our YouTube channel. Also visit us on our website at www.livingyourlifewithoutlimits, where we also offer additional information and free videos each month. Once again, I'm Shannon Jackson, and remember to live your life without limits.